Hey guys, come on, check it out. So this arrived today all the way from Germany, and it is our electric motor. So you can guess what company we actually went with. So in this episode, what we're gonna do is we're gonna talk about this box. We're gonna unbox it for you. We're gonna show you everything that's inside, and then we're gonna show you how we plan on installing this onto our steel sailboat. So let's get going.
This is Luke and I'm Lori, and we're tackling all the challenges of building a fully electric sailboat in Brazil with the hopes that one day we can sail around the world. When we bought our steel sailboat, it came with a 40-year-old diesel motor that unfortunately we don't have any footage of, but we were promised it worked if only the key could be found. And if you know anything about our story, you probably know by now that it didn't work, because nothing in this boat project turned out the way that we thought it would. And with all the problems and repairs we had on the hull, the money that we had saved to buy a motor had almost zeroed out. But what is a boat without a motor? So we pressed on.
We did a lot of research on what motors were available here in Brazil as far as electrical motors go, and we found this company, Torqeedo, which is really fantastic because they're available here. They're available in 50 different countries, so even if we have issues while traveling, they would be able to support us. And we were looking at this new technology, which is cruise pod drives. So there's a lot of options here, but really what was within our budget was the Cruise 6.0 FP Torque Link. And the great thing about it, it does come with support here. It comes with an installer. It was pretty much on the limit of the weight of our boat, but since we were on a budget, this is the best that we could do. And here you can see that it says 6 tons max, which is the projected weight of what our boat's gonna be.
One of the main reasons we bought a steel boat was because it was so adaptable to modifications, and we knew we were going to need to modify it to receive an electrical engine. Now, once we knew what engine we were gonna buy, we planned on cutting a larger opening around the skeg. We used the plans online to create a cardboard template and to ensure that all the measurements would be correct. The result was a fluid look that combined perfectly with the original boat design. But then, the most amazing thing happened to us.
So after seeing our project and learning more about our boat, Torqeedo Brazil did the most incredible thing, and they actually gave us an upgrade. So this wouldn't even be possible without them, especially after what happened to our boat when we had to rebuild pretty much all of the hull. We were really suffering at that point, and they believed in our project, they believed in what we were doing, and they wanted to have their pod drive in Brazil so other people can really understand how amazing their product is. So we are so honored and thankful for this. Now we have the Cruise 12.0 FP Torque Link, our dream motor.
So without any further ado, let's get to it.
Hey guys, what's up? We just received this package from Torqeedo and we will unbox it for you.
All right, now that we open the box, and before we get to the motor and start talking about that, there's a lot of accessories that come with it. So we're gonna get to this first and then get back to the motor. So let's start with this box. We've already opened some of these for you to just speed up the process. So let's get to it. What's inside? Okay, so in this one, we have our propeller. So this is actually the propeller, the standard propeller that comes with our motor. It is like a very durable plastic material, and we decided that we didn't want to go with this one, but it still came with it anyway.
Since we have this extra propeller, we're going to use it as a backup just in case the one we order has any problems.
Next, what are we going to open? Let's do this far one here. Okay. So inside here, this is a great follow-up because this is our new propeller. So we wanted to go with this propeller because it's obviously more resistant. It is metal and it is very heavy. Also, it is a folding propeller. So while we're actually sailing, it'll have less resistance. We'll actually get better movement on the boat. So the great part about this propeller is that it's actually going to help us generate energy when we're sailing. So when the engine is not in use and this propeller is just open, it's going to be turning the engine and actually charging the battery. So pretty cool, but this is not the whole thing. I'm assuming this little box is part of it. See this guy here? Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I was right. So this is the other part of it. So it fits into this. Let's see here. This is some pieces that go along with it. Let's take this out, if I can take it out here. Do it without damaging anything. Okay. So this looks like that propeller actually fits into here, right? I'm not sure I'm gonna be able to do it right now, but it would fit into here and open and close. And then this would actually fit into the back of the motor over here. So a lot of elements that we're gonna have to deal with, but the greatest thing about this motor, and one of the reasons that we actually went with it, is because it comes with somebody that is gonna help us install it. So we're not just alone on installing this motor, or finding out where each piece goes, which is really appealing because, I mean, this is a pod drive, so it's really new technology, and we're gonna have somebody to support us. So, and one of the main reasons why we actually went with Torqeedo, because here in Brazil, we have that kind of support. Last one, sadly. Oh, cool. All right, so here are all the different languages of instructional guides, and here's some, let's see, little gizmos that go with it. Some wires. Here's some more cable. And what's inside this box? Because this is super cool. Check it out. It is the throttle. So this is also not the throttle that specifically comes with the motor. We actually ordered this separately. We wanted it to be on the side so that we can actually control it on the side. And so we're really excited about this one. The great thing about it is it goes forward and back. It moves forward and back without actually having any delays. This amazing component. See this component, we don't really understand how it's attached to the motor or what it does just yet, but we're sure it has a really important part. Perhaps it has something to do with the propulsion. Perhaps it has something to do with how it doesn't need diesel. It just, I mean, perhaps this is what continuously makes the motor go forward. We haven't figured out just yet how it connects onto the piece, but we're sure when we get the directions, it's gonna tell us. Maybe it goes on top or underneath, or, well, last but not least, well, last and least would be the motor, but this is a super special gift that we got actually from Torqeedo, and we wanna show it to you. Because what is an electric motor without a solar panel? Check out this folding solar panel. Now, obviously, this solar panel is not something that can power our motor. Our motor needs way more power than this, but this is a really great thing for small units, maybe for a motor for a dinghy, for instance.
I don't know why I just did that.
Maybe it would be great for powering some small units or something really specific. Like, we also thought of things like if we wanted a heated shower and we just wanted it not to be attached to the battery, and one day we wanted to put out the solar panels and do that. So this is a really fantastic piece. Or if you're, say, you want to go camping, take it with you. It's awesome. It's compact. It comes in this bag. And I mean, we're super thankful because this is really an amazing thing to have. Okay guys, this is the most exciting part, the actual motor itself. And we're excited about this because this is a really special motor, especially here in Brazil, because this is a pod drive. It is a cruise 12.0 FP torque link by Torqeedo. And this is the first ever of its kind in Brazil. So we're really excited to have it here. We're really excited to be part of the firsts for Torqeedo as well. And it really wouldn't be possible without their help and support to have this motor.
So the striking difference about pod drives is that the entire motor is located outside of the hull, and they claim to be quiet, clean, and more efficient than combustible engines.
So the crazy thing about it is because it sits entirely underneath the boat, the only thing that passes through the boat, the only hole in the boat is this tube right here. So this tube, actually, we created a custom fitting, which we'll show you, on how this tap tube actually passes through. So, and this actually is the only thing that enters the boat. This with all of the cables that control the motor itself, and it connects here into the control center. Control center is then connected to however we're gonna operate it in the cockpit, like the throttle, and evidently your iPhone as well can do it. So it's really exciting, all this new technology. So it's a lot of stuff that we're gonna have to figure out as well. But like I said before, the best part about all this is somebody comes and helps us install it, because since it's so new and since it's all electronic and electrical, we're gonna need some professional to tell us exactly what's going on here. Because let's face it, it's the first here in Brazil, so no one else is gonna really know how it's installed and how it's gonna work. Really exciting. It looks like a crazy torpedo.
I feel like Vanna White right now. Like,
it's really heavy. It's very hefty, but even though it's heavy, it's only about 33.5 kilos, I believe, which in comparison to our other motor, the diesel one that we pulled out, which is around 350 to 400 kilos, it is nothing. So even including all of the batteries, the lithium batteries that we're gonna install, which are significantly lighter than any acid batteries that you can have, it's still significantly lighter than the entire setup for a diesel motor. So it's all really exciting, and let's take a look now on how we're gonna install this guy.
To fit the new motor and the folding propeller, we had to increase the opening at the skeg 80 centimeters from the original 50. When we created our cardboard template, we used the measurements provided online, since at this point, we still had not received the motor. The goal was to create a way that the only hole in the hull below the waterline was the one that the wires passed through to the controller. We would put an 8mm steel plate for the motor to be attached to, and that is where the actual bolts would be fastened as well. We then started to cut out the pieces and weld everything together. A stainless steel tube was installed to pass the cables through to the controller, and vertical supports were placed to reinforce the structure. Finally, the frame was sealed off and welded shut. However, testing to see if everything went right won't be until later in the project when we install the engine.
So this is actually really cute. So if you go here under About and then you go to Company, then you can see that Torqeedo was actually built in this tiny little garage, and you can see a little tiny Torqeedo motor peeking out. So I think it only proves that, like, the only reason that Luke and I aren't wildly successful right now is just because we never had a garage.